We gotta stay focused, y'all. And y'all know that if you know the definition of focus, it means it's a mindset, right? It means it's a center of activity. It's where your attention is, where you seem to want to focus on everything. It's your big picture. That's what focus is all about. And I want to ask you guys today is, where are you focused at? And what is your big picture, all right? Now, I'm going to paint a picture here for y'all in a minute. Just hold on. Now, that means it's a point of concentration, seeing the big picture. Now, ask somebody next to you, what's your big picture? See, everything that we see, y'all, in life, sometimes it looks good, but it ain't good for you.
Amen.
Y'all know that?
Yeah.
You know, sometimes, you know, you being a H.H. Gregg or something, you see a big, flat, plasma screen TV. It got the big picture on it. But you know, you ain't paid your mortgage. You know, that means that ain't good for you. You ain't got no business getting that. Or when you see some rims and tires and a system for your car, and you want to get that, but you know, you got to pay child support. Amen. That ain't good for you.
Amen.
Here's one that is the truth, ladies and gentlemen. We walking in the mall, minding our business, focus on our day, and someone walk past you. Lord, have mercy. Look good. He built up, hair's all nailed, it's, you know, looking good. She's like, boom, bye. But do you know that person? Do you know if that person is good for you?
Mm-hmm.
See, y'all, we live in a world where it's giving us a lot of things and it can distract us from what God has for us.
Amen.
We can lose focus on a lot of things of this world. Not saying that a person is a bad person, but you don't know that person. See, you don't know if that person know Christ or not. You don't know if that person, who that person is at all. Right? Okay. We lose focus sometimes, guys, in our everyday lives. We'll be going through a situation when it's hard times, and the first thing that comes to our mind is, in our minds is doubt. We start doubting. Man, I don't know if I'm going to make it through this. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do this. See, we didn't lose focus on the things that we're supposed to do. First thing you're supposed to do is keep the faith, right?
Amen.
All right, okay, y'all know the story about Peter, right? You know the story, everybody heard this story before about Peter, you know. He was looking at Jesus as he was out there in the water. And then Jesus said, come on out here and start walking on the water. And so that's us. No, we leave church on Sundays and we got Jesus all focused in our mind. But by Monday evening, our focus is somewhere else. And just like Peter, he started looking around. He started looking into the storm. Just like we do in our everyday lives. You know, we start looking into the world, start looking at the world's issues, and we lose focus. We start paying attention to what the world has to offer us, and that's when we start sinking and seeing. I'm going to paint y'all a picture here in a minute. Just hold on. The Bible says, while we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal.
Mm-hmm.
Temporary.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Yeah.
But the things which are not seen is eternal.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Here come my big picture. All right, now, in life, we go on and we experience things. And one of the main things that really gets our attention is TV, videos, gossiping on Facebook.
Man.
These things are temporary. Devoting your time to work, spending work, working overtime, and trying to get enough money to buy a car. That's temporary. Like I said earlier, you're in a tough situation and you think there's no way out. You think this is it. I don't know what to do. That situation is temporary. This time you have here on earth, it's temporary. The relationships you get with other people, spend time with another person, that is temporary.
Mm-hmm.
See, we spend so much time, y'all, on computers, on TVs, on the telephone, shopping, Need I say more? But I want to talk about three things real quick that is the main focus of a lot of people's lives today. One of them is an 800-pound gorilla. That's your TV. Mm-hmm. And the other two is a hypnotic beast. That's your cell phone and your laptop or your computer. They got us. A lot of people pay so much attention to those things, they lose focus.
Amen.
Let me explain something to you. 40% of all accidents today happen because of what?
Texting
on the telephone. If you're driving, you're supposed to be focused on the road. You're supposed to be driving down the street to get to your destination. And then somebody gonna hit you on the hip. Hey, I've done it too now. I ain't just, don't shoot the messenger. Somebody hits you on your hip, and we got the nerve to want to try to answer the text while we drive.
Mm.
Where is your focus?
Man.
Focus, man. You know good and well you ain't got no business driving down the street and texting at the same time. All right, I'm going to ask y'all another question. How many of y'all today made a transaction on y'all telephone? At least 10 transactions on y'all telephone today. At least. Between today and yesterday. 10 transactions means hello, calling somebody, texting. That's transaction on your telephone. Your cell phone. I know someone. Now, y'all lying if all you see four hands. I see half of y'all ain't talking on the phone before you got up. Now, I'm gonna ask you one more time. How many of y'all within the last 24 hours have made some type of telephone transaction? At least 10. All right, now I want y'all to keep it honest and I want you to keep it real. Now, how many of y'all in the last 24 hours have made a transaction with God more than 10 times? Meaning fasting, praying, talking. Okay. Amen. I'm gonna ask you another question. How many of y'all were on the computer watching TV for about 15 minutes in the last 24 hours? My God, my God. How many of y'all in the last day had read the Bible for at least 10 minutes? Amen, amen. Do you realize that we can read the Bible 10 minutes every day?
Amen.
We can read the Bible within a year.
That's right.
20 minutes, we can read the Bible within 182 days. Mm. 30 minutes a day, we can read the Bible within 121 days, I'm sorry. But here's the point right here. If you the average person spends 30 minutes a day talking on the telephone. The average person spends 30 minutes a day on the computer, on the internet. And the average person spends at least an hour and a half a day watching TV. That's plenty of time for the world to consume you with a lot of negative things.
Amen.
If you ever watch TV, you will see on a Pepsi commercial a half-naked woman walking in front of the screen. What has she got to do with Pepsi?
Man.
See, our TVs and our radios and our computers are selling up, are putting things in our mind that shouldn't be in our mind. It's putting it right in our face. I know some guys that I counseled that lost their job because they were on the computer watching porn.
Mm.
And I asked them, how does this happen? And well, advertising. Applications. They just pop up. They call them pop-ups. And then you get it consumed to it. You get curious about it. Where's your focus?
Mm-hmm.
All right. I'm going to give you a quick illustration real quick about cell phone, laptops, and a couple more things real quick. Now, we all know with a cell phone, you get a cell phone like a BlackBerry like I have. You get it. You're excited. So you get the cell phone. You take it out the package, right? And then you take out the passage and you gotta read the instructions in order to understand how to work it, right? We're gonna paint a picture here for y'all in just a minute, just hold on. So you read the instructions, and the instructions tell you you can do this with the cell phone. And then you find out the cell phone you got, you can go online. What? Mm-hmm. I first got a cell phone, you could do it and say hello, but now the cell phone's back, you can go online. Now, with the cell phone, you know, we are in contact with the world. So with the cell phone, they made it so you can go online, and then when you get online, you can start downloading stuff onto your cell phone. See, and then they give you apps. They call them apps. Y'all know what I mean? Apps. Apps is like when you get GPS and you get music tones and you get different type of picture things. All kinds of stuff. You get apps. You start loading all these apps onto your phone. Just like we do in the world. We get things. The world has so much to offer us. We just get it. And we just consume it and just take it in and we just take it in. But you notice the more stuff you add onto a cell phone, the quicker your battery dies. So you wonder why you have to keep charging your phone up all the time, because you got all this stuff on your phone. And see, that's how we are sometimes. We got to keep recharging ourselves because we get caught up assuming all this stuff from the world. So we got to get recharged sometimes. Okay. Right, let me explain to you like this. I got this software called Fruity Loops. Fruity Loops now. When I first got it, I was excited. I was like, yeah. I got it. I started like at 9 o'clock. I got it. And like anything else in this world, when you get it, you got instructions. I'm painting a picture here, y'all. You got instructions, and I got the instructions of Fruity Loops, and it said do this and do that, and then I got to the point where it said I could download apps, and then it got to the one part where it said plugins. Or I can get plugins. Plugins are something you connect, something that connects with it. That means when I got plugins to my Fruity Loops, I got a voice box and keyboards and all kind of stuff with the plugins, right? And then by the time I was done doing all this stuff, it was 3-4 o'clock in the morning. I was tired. I had to go to sleep. I need to go to work in the morning. I lost focus. I'm painting a picture here, y'all. All right, let me explain it to you like this. When I was 14, okay? When I was 14 years old, I wanted to sell drugs. Like anything else, everything has instructions. So I went to my cousin. I said, cuz, I wanna be a dope dealer. I wanna sell drugs. He said, you sure you wanna do this? I said, yeah, I wanna do this. He said, well, let me get you some instructions. Everything has instructions. He said, first, here's the rule. Don't get high on your own supply. Number two, don't get high on your own supply. Number three, snitches get stitches. Number four, don't do business with your family. So I thought that's simple. So I started applying this to my life. I started applying the lifestyle of a drug dealer. That's application. I'm applying it to my life. And as I applied it to my life, I started to meet people. I started to get plug-ins. I'm starting to get plugged in with folks. See, I started getting plugged in with folks of the world, like prostitutes and hustlers. And as I started getting plugged in with these prostitutes and these hustlers and these other people who want to buy my drugs, things started happening to me. I started feeling good about myself. And then somebody gave me some free stuff. So they started giving me free stuff. So I'm good now. I'm good now, right? Okay, now here we go. And then after I started getting free stuff, I thought I was down. So I'm so down that now I want to get loaded. So I'm down, loaded. Y'all get this in a minute. So I thought I was so down, so I started getting loaded. And then so I'm starting to get loaded because I'm down and I'm consuming this stuff. I'm getting high. I'm having sex with prostitutes. I'm running the streets. I'm getting dirty money. I'm doing all these things and I'm consuming it into my body. For years, it's happening to me. All right? And then here's what happens. I started getting weak. I started making mistakes. I started looking bad. My body was breaking down. I was actually a dead man walking. Okay? I was a dead man walking. I needed to be recharged, but I didn't know how to get recharged because I was stuck in what the world had to offer me. Okay? And then I met a friend. He told me about Jesus. Okay? Now here's where the script flips. See, these are the things that the world offer you. No matter what the world gonna offer you, it's gonna drain you down. It's gonna make you have to go get recharged. But then, when I met Jesus, he said, there's something that you need to do in order to meet Jesus though, to really know him. He said, you gotta read the Bible. So, I got the Bible. I'm painting a picture. I got the Bible. And he said in the Bible, he said, read it. Because it's got instructions. The instructions. The instructions say, seek ye first. The instructions say, pray and fast. Then there's instructions say, meditate day and night.
Amen.
And there's instructions say, study that word to be approved. Amen. And then so I started doing this. And the more I started doing it, I got a relationship with God. And see, when I got this relationship with God, I started getting energized. It started getting kind of interesting. I'm starting to feel good about myself in the inside. And then this is what happens, y'all. I'm painting a picture here now. Stay focused. This is what happened. God started doing something there for me. He started downloading stuff to me. He started giving me restoration. Then he started giving me joy. Then he started giving me some peace. And then he started giving me blessings. See, that's what happened. He started giving me all these things because now I'm following the instruction of the word. You know what I'm saying? It's giving me a relationship with God. Here's the hit. Then God really got big on me. He said, I'm your big picture. He said, now I'm going to plug you in.
Yeah.
See, then he started plugging me in. He started plugging me in. Plug in means connection. Okay? So I started getting plugged into my church. Then I started getting plugged into pastors. And then I got plugged in with my wife. Oh, that's a plug in. And then he got me plugged in with my buddies at the Connect. I'm connected with people now. He get me plugged in with positive people, see? That's what God do. He gets you connected with the right folks. I remember this one guy, Bishop Mims. When I first met Bishop Mims, he told me to come to his church. This is when I was just starting to walk with Christ. He told me to come to his church. I got plugged in with Bishop Mims, all right? So I'm coming to his church. He said he was doing a rap thing, you know? And I'm like, rap? That's a rap? Yeah, well, whatever. So when I got there, the first person I saw was Will Stump. Yeah. And he was on stage. Yeah. He was rapping. And I said, man, what the? Yeah. And then after that, I was plugged in. Yeah. The first guy from rap I ever seen was Will Stump. And I was plugged in ever since. After that, I met Dale J. I was plugged in. See, God will get you plugged in with folks. If you follow his instructions. You feel me? I'm painting you a picture here now. I'm painting a picture. So here's the deal. All right? The bigger picture, that cell phones can't save your life. You can't get eternity out of a cell phone. A woman or man can't save your life. You can't get saved or go to eternity with a telephone. That car, that money that you got, it's temporary. Can't save your life. That big old TV you like to watch and spend 8 hours a day watching, can't save your life. The bigger picture. The Bible said, set your affection on things above, not things on this earth. God told Joshua to meditate day and night. That means we should communicate, concentrate, regulate, dedicate, and applicate ourselves to Christ daily.
Yeah.
All right? What's your focus? In the world we live in, there's a saying, friend or foe. And as a Christian, I ask you one simple question. Are you a follower or a fan of Jesus? See, we're told to keep our mind focused on God and his word. What's your focus? John 5:39 says, you should study the scripture diligently because you think in them you will have eternity. These are the very scriptures that testify about me, the big picture, eternity. What's your focus? That's all I got.